If you've watched our most recent video, aptly titled Starlink Mod from Hell, you'll know by now the struggles that I had attempting to 12 volt and flat mount swap our Starlink dish. As a quick summary, I accidentally cut the internal Ethernet cable and attempted to patch it with the incorrect butt connectors, blew up our newly purchased router, fried our newly purchased PoE injector, and then experienced extremely long dishy orientation time, slow connection speeds, intermittent connectivity, and lack of a GPS signal. I have since then corrected almost all of those issues. You'll know what those fixes are and if they can help you by the end of this video.
So wait. Hey! Okay, so it's saying poor cable connection, which that makes sense. So maybe I just gotta fix the cables. Yay! I didn't destroy it.
Just some shoddy workmanship.
Hey!
Well, hey there, folks. Welcome back to the Alex Build Stuff Show, or as I also called it, welcome to Struggle Street with your host, Alex Jackson. So just as a follow-up to the video that I posted last week of the 12-volt flat mount Starlink swap that I did, I was told by two viewers, thank you guys, Sylvain and Max, for bringing this to my attention. The use of this aluminum backing was probably not a great idea because aluminum actually interrupts RF signals. One of the issues I was having is that Starlink was unable to find where it is. So the GPS function was not there. I have cut off the Starlink dishy from this piece of aluminum, and I now have a piece of 3/16 polycarbonate to put on the back. So I'm doing that right now. You can see that the dishy has been cut off, looks super gnarly, but it's still functional. So we have the new Lexan backed Starlink flat mount dish up there. The adhesive is currently drying. I'm gonna go around and turn on the system. And we will wait. Well, I turned it on at 11:55 and it is now 11:57. And it is already calculating orientation, and it's disconnected. Anyway, this is already happening way faster than it was. So the whole process of turning on the Starlink and it orientating itself and then getting connected was down to like 7 minutes from like half an hour with the other previous changes that I made. But it just connected in 4 minutes. So I think quite obviously there is a direct correlation between the aluminum and the dishy being unable to connect and stuff like that. So we're online. It's still doing the thing where it disconnects and then connects again, but I don't have any kind of GPS warning or anything like that. So the dishy now has GPS. I'm just waiting for the new updated power supply or converter for the dishy that hopefully should solve the dipping in and out of connection problem. Let's do a speed test here quickly. Holy heck! Holy smokes! Oh my gosh! Holy smokes! the best download speed that we had previous was like 60 megabytes per second. It went right up to 192 and 6.8 megabytes per second upload speed. So this is a huge difference. So there you have it there, folks. Make sure if you're flat mounting your dishy, do not put aluminum on the back. Use plastic. Oh my gosh. I could have solved myself a lot of pain and anguish if I had just not used that stupid aluminum sign. Oh well. Well, hey there, folks. We're back. It's been about, let's say, a week and a half, almost 2 weeks since I did the changes to the Starlink dishy. And just to review, it's been a long time. I replaced the aluminum backing with a polycarbonate backing. I shielded the entire Starlink Ethernet cable. And then I changed the converter. I wired it directly to the battery. And let me tell you, those improvements were big improvements. So I'd say that probably the only thing that remains to do is just change the converter. We do have plans of getting the updated converter, which is a Meanwell converter. It comes directly from China, so it takes a while to get here. And I think that will improve things greatly. We still have that kind of dipping in and out of connectivity, but it seems like the signal is actually, you know, pretty consistent. The Starlink boots up super fast, as you saw. We haven't had really any kind of drop of signal. So I guess like the converter that is in there right now is working well enough for now. I wouldn't say it's like the best thing ever, but we haven't had any issues with it yet. But I do want to upgrade just so that Starlink is not dropping out while we are working. So yeah, I'll show you quickly what we've got, and then we'll conclude this video and say chapter closed. Here we go.
So as you can see, there is the back of the dishy. You can see directly through it with the polycarbonate backing. That really improved things because the aluminum is no longer blocking RF signals. And then you can see this 12 volt to 48 volt converter is wired directly to our high amperage fuse block. And that seems to have cleaned up the noise a lot. So I really suggest making sure that you do not have an interrupted power supply for your converter. Before it was wired to here, and you know, there's lots of power being drawn off of this fuse block. So now it just goes directly here, and then there's a battery line. I can't really see it through the camera, but it goes down to our battery down here. So it's about as clean as you can get it. So that made a really big difference. And then you can see our easy RJ45 connector. This is shielded, and then there is a waterproof shielded RJ45 connector right here. So that means everything is shielded all the way down to the PoE injector.
So I would say with those three fixes, we have a far more reliable 12 volt flat mount Starlink swap. I hope that this video has been conclusive enough for you guys and that it helps someone. If you watched our previous video on the Starlink mod from hell, you'll know that we've been through a lot trying to get this to work. So yeah, if you have the same problems, maybe these will be your fixes. I think that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being here. And until the next one, keep on roaming. Peace.